Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
So before understanding what is osmotic pressure, we should clearly know what is osmosis. So let us see the definition of it and we'll give an example also so that you could know what is actually osmosis. So osmosis is nothing but the spontaneous unidirectional flow of solvent from lower concentration to higher concentration solution through a semi-permeable membrane. It means, I'll give an example of that. Suppose you have resins with you, and resins means, like I'll give another example. Suppose I have give you resins and you are dissolving it in water. So what will happen? The resins which has high concentration of sugar in it and low concentration of water, when are dipped in water, so what will happen? The water which is of low concentration, it will enter in the resin through semi-permeable membrane. In this case will be the skin of the resin, and hence you can see after a few times the resins will fluff up and it becomes, and the size of the resin increases. This happens because of osmosis. I'll give an example related by showing a diagram. So I've drawn a diagram in it and I have separated these two solutions through a semi-permeable membrane. So the left one is a high concentration solution while the right one is a low concentration solution. So according to osmosis, so let me tell you, the flow of solvent will be from where to where? It will be from low concentration to high concentration. Means all the solvent molecules will come towards the high concentrated solution, and this phenomenon, this natural process is known as osmosis. And now study, and now let us study what is osmotic pressure. So osmotic pressure means the excess of pressure on the side of solution that stops the net flow of solvent from low concentration to high concentration solution via semi-permeable membrane. Means the pressure that we will apply so that osmosis should be prevented, or in another word I could say that the flow of solvent should not be from lower concentration to higher concentration, and this prevention by applying excess of pressure is known as osmotic pressure. And what is that? Let me tell you by giving an example. I've mentioned a diagram here. As you can see, it is same like osmosis, but there are few differences and few applications that we are going to do. And what are those? See, this is a semi-permeable membrane which separates these two solutions. One is high concentrated solution and one is low concentrated solution. So it's very much obvious that in osmosis, what will happen? The flow of solvent will be from lower concentration to higher concentration, which means from lower concentration to higher concentration. And we have to prevent it, or we have to stop it. So what we have to do? We have to apply pressure. So this piston that you can see here, I'll press it in downward direction. So what will happen? The flow of solvent which was to be from lower concentration to higher concentration, it will be stopped. Why? Because we are applying excess of pressure. So now the solvent which was flowing from left, which was flowing from right to left, will flow from left to right, or as I can say, it will flow from left to right. So we are preventing, or we are stopping the solvent coming from the low concentration to high concentration. And this, and for this, we require pressure. And this pressure is known as osmosis. and this pressure is known as osmotic pressure. And let me tell you, what is this semi-permeable? And let me tell you, what is this semi-permeable membrane made up of? It can be made up of cellulose, animal bladder, or copper ferrocyanide compound. So this semi-permeable membrane allows only the solvent molecules to pass through it and not the solute. And as you know, a solution is made up of two components. So semi-permeable means half. Permeable means the one who allows. So among the two, only one will be allowed to pass through it, and that is solvent and not the solute. And hence, this particle which I have symbolized as solute particles will not pass from semi-permeable membrane. Only the solvent molecule will pass from the semi-permeable membrane. And by this we have no and by this we have got to know what is osmosis and what is osmotic pressure. So thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you have liked this video, and please don't forget to subscribe Ekeeda.com and share with your friends too. Thank you so much.